Another update on the Ford. The rear wheel cylinders blew out after I replaced the fucking center brake hose back up in there. Yeah. I don't see it. It's under there somewhere. Wheel cylinders worked for like the day or two. Then they blew out. Brake pads are meh. Meh. They'll work. I'm not going to replace them right away. I'm just going to slap these new wheel cylinders in there. I think I can get them in there without taking everything apart, but I guess we will see. I hope so. I hate drum brakes. Hate drum brakes with a passion. It's also starting to rain, so this is major suckage. Got two new wheel cylinders here. It's like 32 bucks locally. So we're going to do this side and then the other side and get my brother to help me bleed it. And it should be good then. We will see. So just a little update here while I'm changing the wheel cylinders. I changed the bleeders for the old ones because the new ones are 10 millimeter. And the other thing in there so fucking tight I had to put a socket on it to get it off. A wrench just slipped. I changed it for the old 3/8 ones because this car has metric tools or standard tools in it because it's a 77 Ford. My 2000 Hyundai has metric tools in it because it's a modern Asian car. Metric standard. I will not use any fucking nuts, bolts, bleeders, anything else standard that are not standard on this car. I'm not some American purist. I don't give a shit about that. I just don't have two fucking tool sets in my car. That's it. This car was built with standard parts. Unless you want to change every nut, bolt, and fastener to metric, which I'm not fucking doing. And no. That's a quest for, that's a quest down the road of insanity. Yeah, no. I'm trying to keep everything standard I can. I figured these threads would be the same. Because those have to be. And I think the thread pitch is pretty similar on the hose as the fitting. I don't know. But anyway, I'm going to throw this bastard in there and squeeze it in there. This is a lesson of do as I say, not as I do. I'm going to be putting this in here. And reusing the old shoes and everything. I did take one spring loose to wiggle it out of there. Don't do that. This is not a daily driver. I don't put many miles in this car. So don't do that. And also don't lay your greasy ass nasty rags on your paint. Unless you really don't have that much paint left to care about. And I don't. Which is kind of nice. Although I do it to the Hyundai too. Because the clear coat's coming off that and the hood's spray painted. But that's beside the point. I clean these stanchions up with a little bit of really fine like 600 grit sandpaper. They're not great. But they should be fine. I swear I think they're called stanchions. I don't know. I don't remember. Anyway, I'm going to stuff this bastard in there. Get everything tightened up on this side. Take the jack out. Leave the jack stand. Go to that side of the jack stand. And, oh yeah, by the way, new AC Delico jack stands. Because I had some Harbor Freight jack stands that were on recall. Anyway, get the side done. Repeat over there. Old bleeders and all that nonsense. And, yeah. Just, you know, bleed them and see if it works. Then new brake shoes later on down the road a little bit. I'll do those a little bit later. I got other shit I gotta worry about. As long as it stops, I'm okay. I mean, I made it home with leaky wheel cylinders. I'll be fine with questionable shoes. Anyway, that's it for this part of the video. Keep watching, and before you know it, you'll see the car with brakes. Cool, right? This is fine. Everything's fine. I don't see a problem with this. Everything's fine. Just fucking fine. So, you know, when you get pissed off and you start cussing the gods or the weather and everything else, you start panicking and throwing your tools in the trunk, leaving these creepy, bloody, streaked fingerprints across, or bloody, fuck, greasy fingerprints across your trunk. Yeah, you know that you're gonna lock your keys in your trunk. And in this case, that means getting this fucking seat loose, which is, there's a mouse nest somewhere in here. It's full hantavirus. And there's like a Pepsi bottle cap over there from the Reagan administration. Ketchup packet from God knows when. But it's fancy ketchup, so it's okay. So, getting this thing out of the way. What the fuck is this? It's nothing. Speaker grill. Is that a roach? Yeah, I think that was a roach. My car has roaches. Cool! So I made a give me my keys back, you son of a bitch, 9000. Because my arms are not long enough to reach all the way in the back of that damn trunk, but this should just about do it. The keys are way back there in the back on the passenger side. I'm pretty sure I can't see them. Matter of fact, oh yeah, I pulled this nasty shit out. The smell started to go away. It's most of this thing that's soaked with rat piss. But yeah, I can't see jack diddly back in there even with the light on my phone. So let's hope that give me my keys back, you son of a bitch, 9000 does a job. By the way, this is broken leg for my tripod, and it doesn't really like the weight, but hopefully it lasts long enough to do this. We shall see. Or I shall, and you'll find out the inevitable failure, soul-crushing failure, where I probably have to pay a locksmith or drill the lock. Yeah. We'll see. That sounds like keys. Holy shit! It worked! It fucking worked! I knew they were buried in there somewhere. Holy shit! It fucking worked! They were in here. They were under this fucking baggie. In this, I kept gripping onto this fucking tire iron. Oh my god, I can't believe that worked. Okay, got them all back together. And just to show you, I'm not lying, I'm making shit up. There you go. You can see that, right? Shiny new shit back here with rusty shit attached to it. Probably not. I don't know.